Police need your help to solve two cold cases.
They are trying to identify these two women. Both their remains were found in Oklahoma City. These images were just released, and Eyewitness News size Wendell Edwards is live with the search for answers. Wendell?
Paul and Jessica, in remote areas like this, you can see behind me just how remote it is. There is little hope for police to go on when they're looking for evidence, but tonight that hope is restored for two different cases, a sketch from one, a recreation from another, and that's why they want you to take a good look at these images, because they're asking for your help. A lot has changed in 10 years since a man discovered a skull in this field. The area is more developed. A house is now on the property. But we still don't know whose remains were found in this wooded area. Back then, investigators searched and searched for clues that would lead them to a killer. They believe this was a homicide. Fast forward to now, and Oklahoma City police released this sketch depicting what the victim may look like. They believe she is a girl between the ages of 13 and 17 years old, who could be a mix of Caucasian Native American or Caucasian Hispanic. And she's not the only Jane Doe police are trying to identify. Take a look at this recreation. Children found remains a year ago this month at Stinchcomb Wildlife Refuge near Lake Overholser. If you know who this is, police desperately want to hear from you. So two different cold cases tonight in need of solving, hope for police and perhaps for families out there still looking for answers. Reporting live in Southeast Oklahoma City, Wendell Edwards, Eyewitness News 5.
Wendell, hopefully someone will recognize these pictures. Police really need your help tonight. If they look familiar, call Crime Stoppers 235-7300.